Good evening, and welcome to St. Mary Parish. We ask that you check your cell phones to make sure they're silenced before we begin. Thank you. Today we celebrate the fourth and final Sunday of Advent, and as the calendar timing is odd this year, there is not a fourth week of Advent, as we are merely hours away from Christmas Eve and the celebration of our Savior being born. There is still time for you to prepare for his arrival through prayer. This celebration reminds us of our Blessed Mother Mary and her cooperation with God's plan, her great loving act for all. May her demonstration of faith, love, and courage inspire all of us to emulate her attitude and selflessness. Our celebrant today is Father William. Please stand and welcome those around you.
Name is hymn number 58, the annual hymn number 58.
Christ would be born in our hearts, in our homes, in our neighborhood. Lord Jesus, you are the way. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ Jesus, you are the truth. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you are our life. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. Pour forth, we beseech you, O Lord, your grace into our hearts, that we, to whom the incarnation of Christ your Son was made known by the message of an angel, may by this passion and cross be brought to the glory of his resurrection. And we pray that you bless Dennis Collins with eternal rest. Through our Lord Jesus Christ your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
Reading from the second book of Samuel. When King David was settled in his palace, and the Lord had given him rest from his enemies on every side, He said to Nathan the prophet, "Here I am living in a house of cedar, while the ark of God dwells in a tent." Nathan answered the king, "Go, do whatever you have in mind, for the Lord is with you." But that night the Lord spoke to Nathan and said, "Go tell my servant David, 'Thus says the Lord, should you build me a house to dwell in? It was I who took you from the pasture and from the care of the flock to be commander of my people of Israel. I have been with you wherever you went, and I have destroyed all your enemies before you. And I will make you famous like the great ones of the earth. I will fix a place for my people Israel. I will plant them so that they may dwell in their place without further disturbance. Neither shall the wicked continue to afflict them as they did of old, since the time I first appointed judges over my people Israel. I will give you rest from all your enemies. The Lord also reveals to you that he will establish a house for you. And when your time comes and you rest with your ancestors, I will raise up your heir, an heir after you, sprung from your loins, and I will make his kingdom firm. I will be a father to him, and he shall be a son to me. Your house and your kingdom shall endure forever before me. Your throne shall stand firm forever." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, to him who can strengthen you, according to my gospel and the proclamation of Jesus Christ, according to the revelation of the mystery kept secret for long ages, but now manifested through the prophetic writings and according to the command of the eternal God, made known to all nations to bring about the obedience of faith, to the only wise God, through Jesus Christ, be glory forever and ever. Amen. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to St. Luke.
Glory to you, Lord.
The angel Gabriel was sent from God to a town of Galilee called Nazareth, to a virgin betrothed to a man named Joseph of the house of David. And the virgin's name was Mary. And coming to her, he said, "Hail, full of grace, the Lord is with you." But she was greatly troubled and pondered what sort of greeting this might be. Then the angel said to her, "Do not be afraid, Mary, for you have found favor with God. Behold, you will conceive in your womb and bear a son, and you shall name him Jesus. He will be great and will be called the Son of the Most High, and the Lord God will give him the throne of David his father, and he will rule over the house of Jacob forever, and of his kingdom there will be no end." But Mary said to the angel, "How can this be, since I have no relations with the man?" And the angel said to her in reply, "The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. Therefore, the child to be born will be called Holy, the Son of God. And behold, Elizabeth, your relative, has also conceived a son in her old age. And this is the sixth month for her, who was called barren. For nothing is impossible for God." Mary said, "Behold, I am the handmaid of the Lord. May it be done unto me according to your word." And the angel departed from her. Sisters and brothers, the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
As a sign of our willingness to enter into the fourth week of Advent, we light this candle. Here I am in a house of cedar, and the Ark of the Covenant is in a tent. My dear sisters and brothers, the first reading is from the book of Samuel, a continuation of the story of David, the person that he was, a man after God's own heart. And after he has completed all his conquests and is resting, he thinks of doing something for the Lord. And he tells the prophet Nathan, "Here I am in a house of cedar, in a palace, and the Ark of the Covenant is in a tent." In other words, he says, "I have decided that I am going to build a temple for the Lord." It's all about I, my decision, my desire, my dream for the Lord. And notice what Nathan says, "Go and do whatever is on your mind." And so all this is in the mind of David, in his mind, his idea, his plan, his thought, his dreams. It's all about me, my. And that night, the word of God comes to prophet Nathan. Go and tell my servant David, will you build a house for me? No, you will not, but I will. Pause here and go back to the book of Genesis. Abraham and Isaac are going up the hill, Mount Moriah, where Abraham is to be sacrificed. And Isaac asks that dreadful question, Dad, here is a firewood and there is a fire. Where is the lamb of sacrifice? And Abraham says prophetically, God will provide. And at the moment of reckoning, when Abraham is about to bring down the knife on his son, the angel of the Lord would come and stop him. In other words, God says, without actually speaking, will you sacrifice your son for me? No, you will not, but I will. And so, notice our God seems to be wanting things from us, when in fact, He is the one doing things for us. It looks like He may be taking away from us, but believe me, He is the one providing us with all that we have. He gives not just His grace, but He gives Himself away in love. That is the story of Christmas. That is the high point of Christmas. For God so loved the world that He would give His only Son. Now come back to the end of the first reading. When you lie in rest, when you are dead and gone and lie with your ancestors, I will raise up someone for you from your lineage, and he will rule over your house forever. And that promise is fulfilled at Christmas. My dear sisters and brothers, when David is talking in terms of I, my, and me, and God says, no, you will not. I don't want yours. You have another example of the mother in the Gospel of the day. She negates herself, not I. I'm nothing. I'm just a handmaid of the Lord. And what does she do? Behold, I'm the handmaid of the Lord. May it be done unto me according to your word. That is the difference between David and our Blessed Mother. That is the difference between Eve and Adam and our Blessed Mother and our Blessed Lord. That is the difference between me and the Mother, and I believe that is the difference between us and her. We always want to do something, we choose to do something, we decide to do something, when we should go back to God and say, what do you want me to do? Again, coming back to Christmas, Prophet Malachi would say, behold, I come to do your will. He speaks for Christ. And that is what Christmas is about. Emptying himself completely. Or go to Philippians, what does he say? Though he was in the form of God, he did not count that a thing to be grasped, but would empty himself and be born as a slave, and he would be obedient even to death on a cross, and therefore God would raise him up. Now, because the mother says, I am the handmaid of the Lord, every generation today calls her blessed, because he who is mighty does great things for her, in her own words. And so, Christmas is actually about Christ emptying himself, making himself nothing, reducing himself to a human being, all because his father wanted him to be born as one of us and move into our neighborhood. And that is why the Word would become flesh and live among us. And so today, I ask myself, David is so full of himself, just like me. David is full of himself, like all of us. When are we going to learn the lesson and like the mother say, "Behold, I am the servant of the Lord," or "Behold, I am the handmaid of the Lord," as the case may be. It is only when we lend ourselves to God's purpose, when we give ourselves away in love, can God really make use of us. To conclude, Mother Teresa would say, "I am a pencil in the hand of God, and He draws with me." Imagine if a pencil that you pick up were to tell you, "Now draw a flower." You would throw that out, because a pencil should lend itself to your use, to your desire, your dream, your plan. That is the way we need to be in the hand of God. And so, as we have walked through the various Advent figures, our journey reaches a culmination with our Blessed Mother, who would say, "Behold, I am the handmaid of the Lord." Like John the Baptist, she says, "He must increase and I must decrease." Or like Prophet Malachi, "Behold, I come to do your will. May your word be done in me." Or even at the Cana festival, the wedding feast, she would say, "Do whatever he tells you." And so, my sister and brother, this Christmas, let's ask for this grace, that you and I may open our minds and hearts so that Christ may be born in us. Master Eckhart would say, "What good is it for me if Christ was born in Mary 2,000 years ago, if he is not born in me, in my culture and in my heart?" All of us are called to give birth to God, because God still has the need to be delivered into the world. And we are all called to be those beacons, those God-bearers, each of us in our own way. And God can use us only when we let go. For it is when we let go that we let God in. That's what David didn't do at the start, but he did towards the end. The mother, right from the word go, would say, "Let it be done unto me according to your word." That is the meaning of her Ave. Has it ever occurred to you that Ave is but the reversal of Eva? Are you with me?
Yes.
Good. In the Garden of Eden, by disobedience, Eve, would bring death into the world. But our Blessed Mother, by her obedience, would bring eternal life into the world. And that is why the fathers of the church would greet her as Ave, the reversal of Eva. Because by her obedience, she would reverse the momentum of the Garden of Eden and would bring life into the world. By eating of the fruit of the tree, Eva would bring death into the world. But by allowing the fruit of her womb to be nailed to the tree of the cross, she would bring life into the world. Like the mother, may we learn to say, "Let it be. Let it be done unto me according to your word." And as we are at St. Mary's, the mother tells us, "Do whatever he tells you." And when we do that, God will be born in us.
O
All these days we are praying the Nicene Creed. Let's try the Apostles' Creed today. Please rise. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried.
He descended into hell. On the third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of God, the Father Almighty. From there he will come to judge the living and the dead.
I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen. Loving God, as we eagerly await the birth of your Son into our hearts and our homes, we ask that you hear the prayers of your faithful servants.
For the Church, may the coming of our Savior renew the spirit and energy of Pope Francis, all the bishops, and the entire clergy to keep moving the Church forward and share a burning faith and love for God with our troubled world. We pray to the Lord.
Let your response be born in us, Jesus.
Be born in us, Jesus.
For the world, as we transition from Advent to Christmas, may our collective heart be changed and may we transition from war and violence to peace and love.
Be born in us, Jesus.
For our nation, may we take the opportunity to unite as your humble servants and to use our abundant gifts to provide hope and equality for all. We pray to the Lord.
Be born in us, Jesus.
For our families, may our hearts be open and our faith strong, and may we always carry out your will. We pray to the Lord.
Be born in us, Jesus.
For those who have died, especially Charles McMahon and Eddie Minn, that they and all the souls in purgatory enjoy the peace and love of your kingdom eternally, we pray to the Lord.
Be born in us, Jesus.
For the repose of the soul of Dennis Collins, for whom we offer this Mass, that God may bless Dennis and lead him home to paradise, we pray to the Lord.
Be born in us, Jesus.
For all the families of our parish community, that as we come together, we will enjoy the togetherness with one another and together with God, we pray to the Lord.
Be born in us, Jesus.
We ask all this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
These are days of giving. If you had a good year, give generously. And if you had a bad year, financially don't feel bad. And the rest of us will rise up and make up for you. But whatever you give generously. There is no compulsion, no guilt involved. Thank you for your love for our community and for the Lord and for your generosity.
Our offertorium is hymn number 707, Hail Mary, Gentlewoman, 707.
Thank you.
Pray, dear sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may become acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands, the praise and glory of his name, for our good and good of all his holy church.
May the Holy Spirit, O Lord, sanctify these gifts laid upon your altar, just as he filled with his power the womb of the Blessed Virgin Mary. And we pray that you bless Dennis Collins with eternal rest through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts. Let's give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For all the oracles of the prophets foretold him, the Virgin Mother longed for him with love beyond all telling. John the Baptist sang of his coming and proclaimed his presence when he came. It is by his gift that already we rejoice at the mystery of his nativity, so that he may find us watchful in prayer and exultant in his praise. And so, with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory as we acclaim:
Holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
Lord, you are holy indeed, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for all for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread through all the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope, Michael our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember your servant, Dennis Collins, whom you've called from this world to yourself. Grant that Dennis, who was united with your son in a death like his, may also be one with him in his resurrection. Remember also our parents, sisters and brothers who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. He paused to pray for Charles McMahon. He died last evening. And for Eddie Mann. Bless them, Lord, with eternal rest. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with St. Joseph, her beloved spouse, with St. John Vianney, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may come to be co-heirs of eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let's offer one another a sign of peace. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world.
Have mercy on us.
Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sin of the world. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
It's because of the policies. Whatever it be, if people are hurt, let's pray that healing may begin this Christmas. That Christmas will be for them truly a homecoming, not just to their families, but to church, the family of God. Let us pray. Having received this pledge of eternal redemption, we pray, Almighty God, that as the feast day of our salvation draws even nearer, so we may press forward all the more eagerly to the worthy celebration of the mystery of your Son's Nativity, as we pray that you bless Dennis, Collins, and Charles McMahon with eternal rest through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Thank you for your presence today. You have indeed fulfilled the Sunday obligation. I hope to see you in church tomorrow. Tomorrow I have the 7 o'clock, 9 o'clock, 11 o'clock. And then I'll be meeting the 1 o'clock Spanish community. And then we have the 3 o'clock, 5 o'clock, 8 o'clock and 10 o'clock. Not counting the 2, 4, 8 and 10 at St. John Vianney. And on Monday, I hope we'll be going back and forth from 7 o'clock to 12 o'clock. By the hour, the Mass is being celebrated. Let's see how we do it. We applaud for him who chose to be born into our midst, who moved into our neighborhood. Know that Father Big and I are here for you, and let's celebrate this truly as a family feast and welcome those who come to us. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Mass is ended. Know that God is with us.
Thanks be to God.
Our session on him is hymn number 42. Come thou Lord.